Hi everyone, welcome to Java Techie. In this tutorial, we'll discuss how to use navigation in Angular. So in previous tutorial, we created one CRUD application using Angular and Spring Boot. So let me reuse the same code guys, so that I can give you the real time scenario where exactly we need to use Angular navigation. Okay, so let's get started. So in this example, we created two components, right? One will be registration component and another one will be search and delete component. So if user want to go to search component, he need to type here URL search, then it will move to the search component. So if I want to go to register again, I need to type the URL manually here, right? Why not we'll create one home component. From home component, we'll add some navigation bar. So when user will click on the navigation tab, then request will go to the corresponding component. This is what the Angular navigation. User no need to type the URL manually here to navigate from one HTML page to another HTML page. That's what we can achieve using Angular navigation. Okay. So for that, let's create one more component here. So let me kill this process. We know to generate the component, the command is ng. Generate component, then give the name home component. So it created home component and it updated in our app.module.ts. Now in routing section, we need to add one more component based on the URL, right? So go to this routing. What I can do, I will copy this. So add it here only. Let's say if user is giving the URL home, then request should come to home component. And now I want to make default as my home component instead of register here, right? So I need to change the URL. Now it is fine. Now let me save this and let me rerun our application. Compiling the source code. So already I open in Google Chrome. So let's go here. Now if I will not give anything here, it should redirect me to the home component, right? That's how we are getting the response home works here, right? So instead of home works, we can add here the navigation bar. So I can use the bootstrap for navigation bar. So if you will go to this bootstrap official documentation, you can find lot of template. Okay, so I will use this one. So let me copy entire source code. Now go to your Visual Studio code. Go to your home component.html. This is what the message we are getting, right? But we don't want this text message. We want here the navigation bar. So add it here. Now if you will save it, now if you will go to your browser, we are getting this navigation bar, right? But we didn't configure any link. And let me remove all the stuff here. So go to code base and let me remove this div. Okay, and if you come here, there is some JPG which will be logo. So what I can do, already if you observe in my assets, I already added one image folder with jt.png. So I can point that one, give the proper folder structure. Then images slash jt.png. Okay, so similarly here we don't have link one, link two, so we can specify our both component. So the first one will be register and second one, let's say search and delete. Okay. And we don't want the third one because we have only two hyperlink, as we created two component and that's what we configured here, right? Register and search. So let me save it. And here we can specify the URL. Let's say for register, we have the URL what we configured here, register, right? So in hyperlink, we can specify this register URL. And for search, we have the URL search. We can specify like that. Now let me save this. Now if you will go to your browser, you are getting the option register, search and delete. So here I can see my logo as well. Okay, so now if I will click on this register, my page is redirecting to the register component, right? So similarly, if I will click on search and delete, my page is redirecting to this search and delete component, right? But as we added here hyperlink, so let me show you. As we added here href, which will be hyperlink, so there will be one problem because it will load all the predefined files. So I will show you that. Let me inspect it. Yeah, so in network tab, if I will click register, unnecessary, it will loading all the files, right? Similarly, if I will click on search and delete, we can see internally it is building all the predefined files and it's loading them. So to navigate from one HTML page to another HTML page, we don't want to lose our performance. Even we don't want to load all the stuff, right? So in order to avoid that, we can add one router link here. Instead of use this href, we can use here router link. This will be provided by Angular. So let me add it here. Now save it. Now again go to your browser. So if I will give the home, it will go to my home component. Now from home, if I will click register, so let me refresh it once again. First let me clear this. So if I'll click register, only it will load the CSS file, no other files, right? Similarly, if I'll go to search and delete, it will doing the all API call, right? Get all users, which is our REST API call, and it is loading the CSS file. So similar way, we can do the backward navigation. Let's say this is my home page. So if user click on this, it will go to the corresponding component. Now from component also, we can redirect our request to the this home component. Okay, so first let me add something in home. It's looking like empty one. So what I can do, go to our code. So in body, I can add this div. So let's go to browser. Yeah, so now go to this register. So in this register component also, we can add something like a hyperlink with home. So let me add that. So better to copy this. Go to each component.html file. So let me close all. Go to this registration component.html. So in down, I can add something like this. Let me add one more div. I can add this and I can give the URL here home. Okay, so that from this registration component.html page, if you will click on this URL or this link, it will redirect to your home component. So let me copy this. I want to add it in our other component, which will be search and delete. So let me add it in end. Yeah. So now let's go to our browser. First let's go to our home page, then click on register. If you user register, so you can see here, right, home is there. So if you click home again, it will go back to the home. If you will go to search and delete, if you will click on this home again, it will go back to the home. So you can design this HTML in better way. I am using the free template provided by Bootstrap. So this is how we can use Angular navigation. That's all about this particular video, guys. Thanks for watching this video. Meet you soon with a new concept.